Hello folks, this is Ajit Balgi from the Happy High and I'm here to show you three easy recipes of iced teas. The whole idea is for you to look beyond peach iced teas. Let's get started.
So the three iced teas of today are pineapple and chamomile, rose and pomegranate, and the last one is a Thai iced tea with an Indian twist. So for the first tea, you need three ingredients: chamomile tea, freshly squeezed pineapple juice, and mint leaves for garnishing.
So for our chamomile and pineapple iced tea, we use a tea bag, and this is a chamomile tea and from TWG, a premium brand from Singapore. I encountered this during my visit, where they had a luxury tea salon with a lot of macaroons and a cup of chai. So that you see fresh chamomile, or rather dried chamomile flowers, and this goes in here and let it brew for around 5 minutes, 5 to 6 minutes, and then take the bag off and let the mixture cool down before we start to build up our drink. Alright folks, so after we've got our tea and we've got it cold, it's time to build it up. So we start with ice first, the most important ingredient in iced tea. We start with ice and we fill the glass up. You can use whatever glass is available at home, taller the nicer. Now we've got chamomile tea from TWG Tea, and we pour that. And then to give it a sweet and a sour taste, I've got freshly squeezed pineapple juice. The ones from the can is really sweet, so this one is not so sweet, it has that tang, so I use a little more. But if you're using it from the can, then be careful as to how much do you use. So it's that simple, there is no added sugar to it, it's all real. And you give it a nice stir. And then you garnish it with some fresh mint leaves and put in a straw. So your chamomile and pineapple iced tea is ready.
So that was our first iced tea, guys, the chamomile and pineapple. Quite delicious and refreshing. It has those earthy notes of chamomile and the fresh pineapple notes coming through. It's easy to make, there is no added sugar, and I think you can try different combinations. You know, you can get as crazy as possible, and this one is easy to make. If you want to spike this up, a little bit of gin, and it makes a beautiful cocktail. So try chamomile, gin and pineapple and you will love it. Let's go on to our second one.
So the second iced tea is rose and pomegranate. We need three simple ingredients: rose tea, freshly squeezed pomegranate juice, and orange zest for garnish.
So to begin with, we need to brew our rose tea. So this is dried roses on a base of lovely Assam tea. So we need to brew it for around 4 minutes, not more than that, and then cool the mixture down. So we add all of it, around 150 ml of water, and then the tea infusion takes time to get ready. So it's in there and it's getting ready. Alright guys, our second iced tea. The rose tea is ready and cooled down, and we are all set to begin. So we start with ice like earlier. We've got this nice transparent cube of ice. We put that in. And then we start off with rose tea. There's a beautiful aroma of roses and very little tannins. A lovely color too. And now we add in the pomegranate. It's freshly squeezed and it has a little bit of tannins, so the drink will get a little bit cloudy, but it's fine. Again, because it's fresh, it is not as sweet, so you need to kind of tweak the recipe based on the sweetness of your juice. So now there is sweet, there is a little bit of sour, and there is an aroma of roses. It's very, very calming. Just to give it a slight twist and to make it a little more refreshing, I'm gonna use an orange peel to get in that freshness. Orange is known for its freshness, and we just need orange oils from the rind, from the zest. So I have a little candle here. You can also use a lighter. So you have to activate these oils first, and I do that, and then I can actually squeeze it over. So just you want to show it as a party trick. You want to be a little gimmicky. You go there, you actually heat the oils a little bit, and then you squeeze it. So all the oils go in here, and you can actually smell the oranges, and you can actually go and line your glass up with this orange oils. Either drop it in or throw it away. So I prefer to drop it in, because it'll give a nice little color to this otherwise just rosy drink. So this orange color adds that freshness. So that's our rose and pomegranate iced tea ready. All right, folks, the second iced tea, again, very natural, no added sugar. You got dried roses, dried tea in there, and freshly squeezed pomegranate juice, and that oil of orange. It's very, very refreshing, very low on sugar. You can pump up the sugar, add sugar syrup if you wish to, but I think this is more about sipping something healthy, and you can sip it a little more as well, because there is not much effect of it on your health negatively. Otherwise, pomegranate is known for its health benefits. Roses are known for its health benefits. And for those who wish to spike it a little bit, then a little bit of vodka in here is gonna do you a little good. So yes, guys, we are ready to move on to the third one, and that's gonna be a big one.
The third iced tea is the Thai iced tea with an Indian twist. We need three ingredients. One is a kadak chai, a kadak black tea. We need sabja or holy basil seeds, and the last one is condensed milk or milkmaid.
So for the Thai iced tea, just like the others, we start with a very strong concoction of CTC, cut, tear and curled tea, the one that we have on a daily basis. So I prefer to use Hasmukh Rai, that's what we use at home, and this is the CTC mixture or the CTC tea that we use as a base for our Thai iced tea. So a real iced tea starts off with the most crucial ingredient, and that's ice. So we've got some ice blocks here, and we fill the glass up with these clear ice blocks. This ice starts to melt slowly as we start putting in the tea. So now the CTC tea goes in, we've cooled it, and then we put that in. Around 200 ml. And now it becomes a Thai iced tea because of condensed milk, milkmaid, mithai maid. There are various brands available, so you need to just pour that in. It's very popular on the streets of Thailand. You can do a coffee also similarly. So depending on how much sugar do you need, that you put in so much amount of milkmaid or condensed milk, and then you give it a nice stir so that it all mixes up. So this is going to be very, very creamy, and this is a different take. Unlike the first two, which had no added sugar, this is quite a sugar bomb based on how much sugar you decide to add. Now, to just give it another variation, that is the bubble tea that is very, very popular in Thailand. I have given it an Indian twist, though. I've put in some sabja or holy basil seeds that we've got it puffed by soaking it in water, and then we take around 1 teaspoon of the same, and then soak them in water. And now that adds to the texture when you drink this, and it's gonna give it a nice crunch as well. So that's your Thai iced tea with a slight Indian twist of holy basil seeds ready. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed seeing the iced tea. It's quite creamy and delicious. Just a shot of whiskey and you can spike this up just like the others. And this will be that perfect drink for the weather. Anyways, guys, so the idea of making these iced teas were to
let you think beyond peach iced tea. So there is so much more that you can do with teas, and I hope this video helps you explore teas. I'll bring you more. Thank you.